The term jebaited has been used in reference to AMD's reasoning behind their price drop on the new Navi GPUs. We thought that was all. That was what they were shooting for, and that's what they meant. Now, many people out there believe that this was the case. Other people believe that this was just them covering their butt for having to drop the price once NVIDIA launched their RTX Super lineup. Now, with some information that's going on out there today, I think the word jebaited might actually mean the entire Navi lineup, and that is something that we're going to be talking about here today. I think that they may have jebaited NVIDIA into a position that they really can't back themselves out of. So this is sparked by this article over here on Tech Power Up. The AMD readies a larger 7-nanometer Navi 12 silicon to power the RX 5800 series. Now, I believe the 5800 and 5900 series would be RDNA 2 coming out later this year or early next year. However, it is theoretically possible that they could just go ahead and make the RX 5800 with RDNA 1, get that out now, or within the next couple of months, and compete that entire time frame while finishing up RDNA 2 for the 5900 series. So this leak doesn't really have too much. This is based off of this comment over here, basically just saying that Navi 12 will be a big GPU. Now, this is a little strange because typically the naming scheme goes the lower the number, the bigger the die. So Navi 12 being larger than Navi 10 doesn't make sense unless you think of this word once again. If AMD really wanted to bait NVIDIA into showing all of their cards, they would basically screw up their own naming scheme, which doesn't matter to us as consumers, not really anyway, and go ahead and basically make the Navi 12 chip, call it the Navi 10, let NVIDIA think that that's going to be the largest GPU out this year, and then come out with something bigger. So this might actually be the case. So what exactly could we expect from a larger Navi chip, an RX 5800? So that's what I want to talk to you guys about here today. I have some ideas as to what this could look like, even with RDNA 1. And to be honest with you guys, just looking at pure numbers, it most certainly will be able to compete with NVIDIA. All right, so looking at these numbers here, I just took the RX 5700 XT and then just increased everything by 50%. Obviously, this is unrealistic. Those clock speeds will never happen. And this price point, probably also not going to happen. And this TDP level, probably not going to happen. However, if we change things up a little bit, and if the 5800 XT, which will be obviously the higher end model, there will be a cut down version of this, coming in 60 CUs, this would make a lot of sense. Same clock speeds or similar clock speeds to the 5700 XT, this would bring it around the 300 watt TDP range. As obviously we're not increasing clocks, then once again, it won't scale 50% just due to adding the cores. So I think that they could be able to squeeze that in the 300 watt TDP range, and then we'd be looking at $699. I think that's more realistic, putting it in direct competition with the RTX 2080 Super. Now, another option that AMD could do is use the 5700 non-XT clocks. That would be far more efficient. We know that the 5700 is a lot more within AMD's efficiency curve. So they could go that route, bring down TDP a bit as well. I don't think the price would change. They're probably going to be shooting for $699. And overall, this is the specs that I believe that they will be going for, essentially 50% bigger than their RX 5700 XT. Now, if we take a look at Tech Power Up's numbers right here, we can see where everything lands. So if you look at the RTX 2080 Ti, that's coming in at 118%. This is on their RTX 2080 Super review. And then the 5700 XT comes in at 76% of the 2080 Super. So we're looking at a pretty good delta between these two right here. That's about 40% difference in performance. Now, realistically, if AMD does bump up their core count by 50%, they're not going to gain a full 50% scaling. However, we do know that Navi is a scalable architecture. That's what they're talking about. But we could assume reasonably at least a 35 to 40% performance increase, depending on clocks and TDPs that AMD would want to go with. And if you pop that on there, you're basically looking at an RTX 2080 Ti competitor. It may be slightly slower, it may be slightly faster. There's no way to know for sure, but it would be close enough to where nobody would actually care. The other interesting thing that we can take a look at is the 2080 Ti actually has 4352 FP32 cores, whereas I believe the 5800 will only have 3840. So it'll actually have less FP32 cores than the 2080 Ti, but should be within striking distance. And this really ties into what AMD said with their scalability. I believe that Navi can scale higher, better than Nvidia's cards. You can see that Nvidia had to go from 2944 on the original RTX 2080 all the way up to 4352 just to gain a 30% performance increase. So that is a massive increase in die size just to gain a little bit of performance. I believe that the Navi architecture is going to be proven to be more efficient overall, at least in terms of scalability. Now, as far as pricing goes, it actually makes a lot of sense, since AMD went ahead and positioned the 5700 XT at $399 directly against the RTX 2060 Super, all the while offering RTX 2070 Super-like performance, essentially offering one tier higher graphics performance for a much lower price. So this is a strategy that we've already seen AMD implement, and this actually feels very reminiscent to the launch of the original GCN architecture. If you think about it, the 5700 XT is very similar to the 7870. It's a 256-bit card, competed very well, came out at $349. Now we have one at $399, but you know, that's 7 years later, so that kind of makes sense. The new 5800 XT will likely be the descendant or pseudo-replacement for the HD 7970. Being a 384-bit card, I do believe that it'll be priced a bit higher at that $699 price point because they would be competing with the RTX 2080 Super at $699 while offering 2080 Ti-like performance. Now, in this video right here, right before they announced the 2080 Super, I basically lambasted Nvidia for not lowering the 2080 Ti and basically rebranding it as the 2080 Super. Had they done that, basically AMD wouldn't be able to make this move and essentially make most of Nvidia's lineup look pretty silly. Because the 5700 XT right now pretty much makes the $300 to $700 price point irrelevant, as it's the best bang for the buck. And then bringing out something close or slightly beating the 2080 Ti at $699 will make the rest of the high-end lineup from Nvidia look irrelevant. Now, this is going to force Nvidia into a weird spot where they're either going to need to drastically reduce prices again, which is not going to make shareholders happy because they've already refreshed their lineup. And the only real option that they have is to come out with a new flagship card and maybe bring down the 2080 Ti to its MSRP or a slightly lower price. Unfortunately, that's not really going to work too good because they just came out with the 2080 Super, so they're not going to be able to go too much lower than the $999 MSRP, so they'll be trying to compete with a $700 card with their $1,000 card, and unfortunately, that's just not going to work. And this is the reason why I started this video off with the word jebaited. I think that this could be true. If AMD does stick with RDNA 1, they can get out a larger die, a 384-bit die, here this year, within the next couple of months. It's absolutely, theoretically possible. The die size still wouldn't be that big because if we take 251mm squared and all we have to really do is just add 50%, now, granted, it wouldn't even be this large, but worst case scenario, they'd be looking at a 376mm squared die. That's not that big, and they should be able to produce that, especially if they're selling them for about $700. That shouldn't be a problem. And then cost also scales linearly. And as I said, in my opinion, they'll actually go more than 50% on the price, so they'll actually be raking in higher margins, which is what you typically do in the high end. However, I think most people would be just fine with 2080 Ti-ish performance at $699. As I mentioned in that video where I was talking about the 2080 Super, a lot of people would have been totally cool with Nvidia just dropping that down a tier and charging the price that they should have charged originally. People were okay spending $699 on 1080 Ti's, pretty much the whole generation. And I think people would have been okay spending $699 this entire generation on 2080 Ti's. But NVIDIA got greedy and wanted to milk those margins. So I think AMD realizes that they're backed into a corner because they can't do much about price. And if they launch a competitor at the price that they should have been this whole time, much like what they did with the 5700 XT, delivering near 1080 Ti performance for $399, essentially delivering the GPUs that everybody wanted this entire generation at the prices that we expected. Now, the only real cost is the TDP. It's going to be high. I don't know how that they would do it. I think either going with the higher TDP or the lower clock speeds, either one would work. Might make sense for them to go with the lower clock speeds for the reference models or, you know, the basic models, and then let AIBs put different coolers on them and then overclock them, pre-overclock them. That, I think, would make a lot more sense. Go with the lower TDP. This would make a lot of reviewers happy because they'll run cooler, quieter. I think that would make a lot of sense for AMD to do, but they're going to make their cards look as competitive as possible. However, we know the $699 price point right now is very weak. It's essentially still 1080 Ti level performance. It's only a little bit higher. It's not really that great. So if AMD can come out with essentially 2080 Ti performance at that price point, I think they're going to be sitting pretty well. Even if it's a little bit lower due to these clock speeds with AIB models and overclocking, allowing people that don't really care about TDP that much, allow them to clock their GPUs as high as they want. That makes the most sense to me, but we'll see what they do. Now, guys, I want to preface this saying that, I mean, this is all speculation. This is all rumor. There's nothing concrete here. However, this does make sense. When you kick back, you look at the old 7000 series, the GCN launch, it would be as if AMD just launched the 7870 first and then brought out the 7970 later. Now, the big difference here is NVIDIA was first to the party this generation, instead of coming out after the 7000 series and being able to assess the situation. AMD has been able to see what the situation looks like and go ahead and plan accordingly. So that's the reason why I think that, yeah, they may have debated NVIDIA into pricing things at certain levels, because NVIDIA could have done what I suggested and bring down the 2080 Ti to $699. And I think AMD knew if they announced the 5800 XT before the 2080 Super launched, that NVIDIA might actually do that. So that is where I think they may have debated NVIDIA, is not so much with the 5700 XT and the price drops and all that, because the 2070 Super is still reasonably competitive. I don't think it's worth the extra $100, but we're not talking about a lot of money, and it is a little bit faster. So that never really made a lot of sense to me, but on the high end, not basically locking the 2080 Ti out of that $699 price point because they can't. I mean, they can't lower it to that price point and then just completely lower their 2080 Super. I mean, technically they can, but it's not going to look good. It's going to look very bad to their investors. People are going to lose a lot of confidence in NVIDIA if they do it. Now, they might have to if they're losing a lot of market share. The other option is they might scramble and get themselves to 7nm really fast and build an even larger die to compete. But then AMD can simply just scale everything down. They don't have to be on top right now because they are working on RDNA 2. The 5900 series will probably be the new RDNA 2 that'll come out next year. So by the time NVIDIA gets something out, AMD will have some sort of answer. So if this is true, this is really, really interesting. Things might get a lot more interesting this holiday season in the graphics card market than we were anticipating. We'll find out here soon enough. I would expect announcements probably in September to get everybody hyped up for the holidays if they will be out by then. So I'm pretty interested to see what they do, because if this is the route and this is the game plan, then I can firmly say they did debate NVIDIA to basically boxing themselves in. And this was really smart because they're going to own pretty much the mid-high end, which is the $399 range, and then they're going to own the high end, because nobody's going to be spending $1,200 on an NVIDIA graphics card when AMD's got a $700 competitor. That is too big of a difference. Nobody's going to do it. You know, the $100 difference from the 5700 XT to the 2070 Super, that's close enough that some people will throw money away, but nobody's going to throw away $300, $400, or $500. Nobody with any common sense anyway. Well, already, guys, Let me know what you guys think down in the comment section below. Do you think that this is plausible? Does this make sense for AMD to do? I think it does, but let me know what you guys think. And if they do this, do you think that they really did jabate NVIDIA into basically boxing themselves in and forcing them to either scramble to a new generation faster than they wanted to? Or do you think NVIDIA will just go ahead and lower prices and maybe come out with like a top tier 7 nanometer card and then just scale everything else down? I think that that's an option as well. But I don't know. NVIDIA is going to be really up a creek because their die have to be so much larger. And if they go to 7 nanometer, they're going to have a hard time competing on price. They might be able to take the performance crown, but I don't think that they can compete on price, not anytime soon. But let me know what you guys think down in the comment section below. If you like this video, please hit that like button. Please subscribe. Please share with friends. That really does help me out. If you want to help support the channel for as little as $1 a month, you can really help me get tech on hands and talk with me over on Discord. And that's all I have for today, and I will catch you guys in the next video.